Oh, hello, hello. This Blue Star Warrior One, all the glory goes to Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior. Today I feel led to read Genesis chapter 11. Genesis chapter 11 from the King James Version of the Holy Bible. Let's begin. And the whole earth was of one language and of one speech. Could you imagine the whole earth having one language and one speech? Everyone spoke the same language. And it came to pass, as they journeyed from the east, that they found a plain in the land of Shinar, and they dwelt there. And they said one to another, Go to, let us make brick, and burn them thoroughly. And they had brick for stone, and slime had they for mortar. And they said, Go to, let us build us a city, and a tower whose top may reach unto heaven, and let us make us a name, lest we be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth. And the Lord came down to see the city and the tower which the children of men builded. And the Lord said, Behold, the people is one, and they have all one language, and this they begin to do, and now nothing will be restrained from them, which they have imagined to do. Go to, let us go down, and therefore confound their language, that they may not understand one another's speech. Now what's going on here is that Nimrod, also known as Emerker, is building a tower, the Tower of Babel, and it's a tower they want to reach to heaven. Now, if you ever read the book of Jasher, which is really good. Now, I've only heard Jasher on tape. I don't own the book. And you can look it up on YouTube and get the book of Jasher on tape. You'll learn a lot about King Nimrod, a.k.a. Emerker, which is another name for him. And how he built the Tower of Babel and how he shook his fist at God. And wanted to build the tower up into heavens and make war with God. That's what he wanted to do. And God saw that tower and destroyed it and confused the language of the people. He scattered them abroad. And so the Lord scattered them abroad from hence upon the face of all the earth, and they left off to build the city. Therefore is the name of it called Babel, because the Lord did there confound the language of all the earth. And from hence did the Lord scatter them abroad upon the face of the earth. These are the generations of Shem. Shem was 100 years old and begot Arphaxad 2 years after the flood. And Shem lived after he begot Arphaxad 500 years and begot sons and daughters. And Arphaxad lived 35 years and begot Salah. And Arphaxad lived after he begot Salah 403 years and begot sons and daughters. And Salah lived 30 years and begot Eber. And Salah lived after he begot Eber 403 years and begot sons and daughters. And Eber lived 430 years and begot Peleg. And Eber lived after he begot Peleg 430 years and begot sons and daughters. And Peleg lived 30 years and begot Reu. And Peleg lived after he begot Reu 209 years and begot sons and daughters. And Reu lived 230 years and begot Serug. And Reu lived after he begot Serug 207 years and begot sons and daughters. And Serug lived 30 years and begot Nahor. And Serug lived after he begot Nahor 200 years and begot sons and daughters. Could you imagine living 200 years? Man, that's a very long time. We can't even imagine it. And when the average person lives 75, 78 years. Now Nahor lived 29 years, and begot Haran. And Nahor lived after he begot Haran 119 years, and begot sons and daughters. And Haran lived 70 years, and begot Abram, Nahor, and Haran. Now these are the generations of Haran. And Haran begot Abram, Nahor, and Haran. And Haran begot Lot. And Haran died before his father Terah in the land of his nativity, in Uar of the Chaldees. And Abram, Nahor, took them wives. The name of Amram's wife was Sarai, and the name of Nahor's wife, Milcah, the daughter of Haran, the father of Milcah, and the father of Ishkah. But Sarai was barren. She had no child. And Terah took Abram his son, and Lot the son of Haran his son's son, and Sarai his daughter-in-law, his son Abram's wife, and they went forth with them from Uar of the Chaldees to go into the land of Canaan. And they came unto Haran and dwelt there. And the days of Haran were 205 years, and Haran died in Haran. And remember, Abram later on becomes Abraham, and his wife Sarai later on becomes Sarah, and they do have a child, their son, Isaac. And remember, they're the father, Abram, who becomes Abraham, is the father of Israel. Interesting enough to know. And if you remember, Abraham's great-great-grandfather is Shem, and Shem's great-great-great-grandfather is Noah. And then Noah's father is Lamech. Lamech's father is Methuselah. Methuselah's father is Enoch. Enoch is the first person ever to be raptured. He walked with God, and God loved him so much, he took him up into heaven, and so he never died. And if you go all the way back from Enoch, you'll get back to Adam. Interesting, isn't it? They're all connected. We're all connected. And if you notice, as you read, their lifespans get shorter and shorter. With each generation, their lifespans are getting shorter and shorter until they get to the present day, where people say if you live to 65, you lived a long life. 65 is nothing compared to these people's life expectancies. I mean, look at this. Lived 430 years, no, 430 years. 430 years. Could you ever imagine living 430 years? No, we couldn't imagine. We couldn't imagine living that long. No, it would be like, that would be an impossible for us to imagine living that long. To me, my measly 27 years on this earth seemed like forever. Whereas these people would think like 200 years is nothing. Our ancestors living 200 years. Amazing. Just simply amazing. But I don't think our bodies, because as, you know, with each generation, I don't think our bodies could handle living 200 years. Whereas their bodies could. I think there's differences between us and our ancestors and how their physical flesh was designed compared to ours. Because I couldn't see people nowadays holding up. I mean, I have a grandmother who's like 91, 92, I think. No, she's 92. And she's barely hanging on to life at an age of 92. She's blind. She's deaf. She's lost her kidneys, lost a bunch of her toes. Her health is falling apart. And, you know, partly could be because of the food and water and everything in this world. But I also think it's like, we're not designed to live that long. There are people that were health nuts and ate good food and lived up to 102 and then croaked. I think there's like a limit, a life expectancy limit, that how far along our body, our fleshly body can last. I don't think we could make it that long. I don't. I really don't. I don't think we could live that long. So, but that's my opinion. You take that up with Lord Jesus Christ, ask him for guidance, ask him to show you the truth. God, please be with all my subscribers, all my viewers, and their loved ones and family members. Please lead all my subscribers, all my viewers, and their loved ones, and my parents to Lord Jesus Christ. Please wash them all in Lord Jesus Christ's blood. Please bless them all with the heart healing deliverance they need. Please do all these things as long as they have not taken the mark, and if it is in your will, God, Lord Jesus Christ's holy name, amen, amen. Peace be with you.